All right, this insane. Draw another black mana. Hard pressed to lose. And he mulliganed. Not good for him. Good for us. Did not get our black yet, but we curve out pretty well now at least. I have to assume he has some type of flyer coming, but I'm still going to leave with the Plague Singer. Most of his deck is flyers. He probably has like a Scudder or something. But we can reap like Grasp of Darkness to take it out or whatever. We did not do so this time, but that's fine. Hopefully we grip Swamp this turn, get a Grasp and a Necropede. We'll take our three. Another Scudder. Jeez. Alright. So I can Carrying Call or just Copper Mirror. And I think this is a situation where I want to attack with this Contagious Nim. I have a feeling he will block. But we have enough Infect coming that I'm not too worried about losing Contagious Nim. Alright, no blocks there. So we're going to play a Copper Mirror and a Necropede. Next turn we have Acid Web Spider, which will hold the fort for a while. Shikari, sure. Alright, so we're just gonna bash with everything, I guess. He'll probably just block the Contagious Nim here. And then hopefully Acid Web Spider can hold off his squad. If it doesn't, if he has an arrest or something, we're going to be in trouble. But in that case, we're going to be wanting to be aggressive with our attacks anyway to get in as much poison damage as quickly as possible. But yeah, he's just going to block there, go to 4 poison, lose one of his guys. This also lets me know he probably doesn't have equipment in his hand. Maybe he does, but I can't even imagine equipment that costs 4 that he would be playing like... Oh, now he has Dispense Justice. Okay, so we will sacrifice this guy. Shrink that guy. Yes. So that situation comes up a lot, in case anybody doesn't know it. You basically wait till after combat and all the damage is resolved, then you Dispense Justice. In this situation, it killed a Necropede, but it also shrunk a Necrogen Scudder, so it wasn't the worst for us. And he was down to 1 card in hand, which is also good for us. His attack should be stifled here. And if nothing else, he has us on a 3-turn clock now instead of the 2-turn clock that it was before. Forest, sure. We will run out a Blight Mamba and then play a Carrying Call end of turn. Windhawk Idol is annoying, but not end of the world. Swamp, sometime. Jeez. Alright, so I'm just going to attack with Blight Mamba here. He said this is evil. I don't know what that means, but... Maybe he has another Dispense Justice? I don't know what this is evil is. Maybe is he slow rolling me? I don't know what's going on. Alright, so he's at 5 poison. We get to play a Trigon and probably make a dude. Is he gonna tap 2 of my guys? It's not lethal. Can't. I don't know what this is evil is about. Maybe it just meant like Blight Mamba is really good in this board, which it obviously is. Sure. I could have attacked with my Carrion Call tokens last turn, but I think I want to save them for something like Untamed Might. Dead guys. No corpse curse here, though. Drew a land, or he had a land in hand. Dude. Well, that was a good one. So here we're gonna just bash with Blight Mamba and one infect guy. I can regenerate and make another one in a turn. Which should be enough next turn to kill him, probably. Otherwise, I'd have to attack with all my guys. He trades with one of them, kills the 3 of them, including a Plague Stinger. I get in for basically the same amount of poison. His guys get shrunk a little bit. But, like, alright, so now he's got a 1-1 Necrogen Scudder, so his offense has dwindled a little bit. A quarter shield's fine. So a lot of mana. Mere Battle Sphere. Okay. Nothing I could really do about that. He can almost kill us with an attack. He taps 5 mirror, shoots us down to 6, and can hit us for 3 in the air. We're also going to make another dude in a turn, though. And hopefully grasp. Alright, so Swamp is pretty big for us. I think here, alright, so he's at 6 poison, so that's obviously a very relevant number. We don't want to tap too many things, because we need to be able to deal with this Battle Sphere. What is the play? He gets a quarter shielded up. He could actually tap 6 mirror, including itself. Puts us to 5. But then he's dead on the swing back. So, I think I just want to attack with a Blight Mamba, and no, Blight Mamba's not even a good attack. I think I just want to attack with the guy infiltration lens on it and see what he does on his turn. This will put him to 7 or draw me 2 cards. Either one of those is fine. If he does attack with a Battle Sphere, I'm going to have to do everything in my power to kill it, because the second attack will kill me. But it depends on how many guys he taps, etc. We have one more creature coming off our Trigon. I don't know, it's going to be a close one. Battlesphere is a beast of a card. If he didn't have the Battlesphere this turn, we would have won. He would have had four blockers. We would have grasped something, so he goes down to three blockers. We get through with one, two, three poison guys. Ooh, we're going to draw some cards here. Yes, I would like to draw some cards. Alright, so we're going to play this dude. I need to have regen, plus make a dude, plus grasp open, so I'm not even going to equip the infiltration lens. He said if I didn't have it, I probably do now. He's probably talking about Untamed Might, I would assume. But we did get rid of a mirror there, so now we're not even at two attacks with the mirror battlesphere, so maybe we can block it or whatever. Wait for his attack. If he attacks with all of his flyers, we can get in there with Plague Stinger, which is pretty big. I don't know what his attack's going to be, to be honest. We get another guy, which is relevant. And then we get Grasp, so we're shrieking his team. So we're going up plus one, he's going down minus one. He's only got one card in hand, so... then if he attacks, we get a pretty safe blocks to where we're not taking any damage from combat, which means the only damage we'll be taking is from your Battlesphere. But we just shrunk that by one, making it only five, so now we don't die to two attacks from it. It takes three, unless he plays another mirror. But then we can grasp the mirror if we have to. Alright, let's see what he drew. Oh, he's just equipping a quarter shield, I guess. Probably the mirror battlesphere, so he can tap itself. Yep. We'll see what his, how many mirror he taps before we make any decisions. Sure. See, it's alphaing. This looks like an alpha to me. I don't know why. So we can kill the Necrogen Scudder, block Mirror Battlesphere, regen, block Glint Hawk Idol, an Acid Web Spider, block the 1-1 Necrogen Scudder with the Zeri's Archers. Then we have the Mirror Battlesphere is already dealt with, so we have 4 for his 4, if we even want to do that. Like, Copper Mirror is probably the easiest card to throw in front. Then we even have an extra card coming off the Trigon. So, not sure... He obviously doesn't know we have Grasp, so he thinks maybe he gets in for one extra damage here or whatever. But he doesn't. Alright, so he's going in on that guy. We'll see how many mirror he taps. One, two. Alright, so we were dealt 9. So I was just going to block this guy. Could kill it, but it's got 10 toughness, so I'd have to like exhaust a lot of things. So I'm obviously just not going to do that. Regen. Make a dude. And then I almost think I have to kill this Scudder, because otherwise he wants to play Momir basic. Do this now, I might be bottlenecked on mana on my turn. But I think the surprise factor might be bigger. Not sure. I think I'm just going to take this out now. And then, eh, I'll wait. It's probably smarter to wait, see what we draw. Okay, we drew a land. Soup one of these guys up. Get in with it. I suppose I could be blocking with Coppermere and therefore suiting up like a Blight Mamba instead here and regenning. Not sure if that's better or worse. Because I could block his Mirror Battlesphere with Coppermere, who is, for all intents and purposes, dead. Draw me some cards. I'm actually pretty fine with this either way. He's trying to decide if he has a profitable block here. He's blocking with the Scudder. That's pretty annoying. Because I could have last gasped that. Okay. We will now play a Forest. Play a Blight Mamba. Pass the turn. Could have equipped there. Probably should have equipped. But that's okay. Blister Grub. Okay, that's annoying. This turn, I might have to try to kill this Battlesphere. I'm not sure if I can, but I'll try. 9 toughness is so much. He can shoot me for 5, put me to 4, then Blister Grub is basically lethal along with the Battlesphere. So that's pretty scary. Means I'm going to have to draw something next turn to win. Maybe an Untamed Might or Contagion Engine probably gets there. Contagion Engine definitely gets there. I have 6 to... Actually, I don't get to use it right away. But I have to kill a bunch of Mirror, a Necrogen Scudder, and shrink a Blister Grub without killing it. Which is not too relevant, but... So he's got no cards in hand. He's basically trying to decide what his best attack is here. I mean, if I were him, I would just be attacking with the Battlesphere and dice. I don't know how many. Probably enough to make it lethal next turn. Oh, he's not attacking with anybody. Well, that's interesting. So we're going to charge this. And we're going to still sit on our grasp. Blackleaf Goblin. It's pretty good. Brawl. We want to be able to regen this, regen the other thing, make a dude, and grasp, which we can do. He's making a bird guy. So he's going to block with his bird. Maybe he'll block with a team and we'll get to draw 40 cards. He's got to be worried that if he doesn't block here, I can Untamed Might. But at the same time, I'm drawing extra cards every time he does block, so... Shocking, whoa, I don't know if he, I think he's trying to deck me here, but it's a May effect. So I get to draw a ton of cards, kill a guy. I don't think this is what he wanted to have happen at all. Since it's a bunch of May effects, we're gonna make this. We're gonna kill a mirror, actually. That gonna be number one. We're gonna put all these on the stack. I know there's a way to. I think he's just trying to deck me. Yeah, he just said, haha, it's a May. So, I just got to draw a ton of cards without decking. Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Yes, I do. Alright, we'll do one more. That was a good one. No. 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 Alright, and I guess I just regen this guy still. Killamere. Play a wing. I could play Sylvanas Replica, shoot something, and wing puncture, which is pretty good. Otherwise, I can do, let's see, Plague Stinger, Wing Puncture, plus Untame My, or Plague Stinger, Wing Puncture, and Grasp. I got a takes two. I don't think I've, have I played a land yet? Yeah, I played a land. Alright, Sylvanas Replica is effectively four mana. Leave me with two, so I can play Spell Bomb, Sylvanas Replica, and Wing Puncture. If I go Grasp, that takes up two, leaves me with four. I can go Grasp, Plague Stinger, Wing Puncture. It's not that good. Yeah, I think. At the same time, I do want to get more Poison guys into play. So maybe I just go. So I got to deal with this Battlesphere. It's the only way I'm going to lose a game. So I'm going to play this guy. A Spell Bomb, a Wing Puncture, and Sacrifice. And I'd rather save the Wing Puncture and save information and discard some of these lands that are useless anyway. He says he guesses he should read cards. But, I mean, it was a valiant effort on his part to force me to deck. Instead, Infiltration Lens turned into Necropotence, which is quite the card. So yeah, I'll be killing a bunch of his guys this turn. And then I have Blackleaf Goblin as a haster and Untamed Might, so game should be over after this. Assuming his one card is not a Contagion Engine, which would be a blowout. I don't think I would win it if he Contagion Engine, to be honest. He's also down to 4 minutes on his clock, which is not good for him. I'm trying to console him. I'm sure he's just trying to figure out a way out of this. He can attack for six, but I'm going to blow up a Battlesphere as soon as he goes to combat. I will then Wing Puncture 2/2 Flyer. Whether that is Glinthawk Idol or Necrogen Scudder, I'm not sure. If Glinthawk Idol activates, I'll probably still Glinthawk Scudder, to be honest. I'm not sure if our choice of spells afterwards was the best. I think getting rid of the Mirror Battlesphere is important here, just because it is so dominant in this particular board state, and we're going to win next turn with Untamed Might anyway. So getting out, like, an extra poison guy and being able to grasp or whatever is not too important. Here comes the Desperation Alpha Strike. And even if I take it all, I'm taking 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it's not even lethal. And I'm obviously not taking it all, so. Blister Crub, getting in there. You got it. Wing Puncture. This guy on this guy. Necropede. Alright, so he currently has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blockers. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 guys. He could instill infection us, but, or he could, I guess instill infection isn't out as well. If we play Blackcleave Goblin, we still have 5 mana open, which is enough to kill him. And we get around pretty much everything. So we're going to do that. I could also grasp him. Yeah, I'm going to play this guy, and we're going to attack with everything plus 2 just to avoid Dispense Justice. Sure. There's Soul Parry, which is a card that we need to watch out for. Let's see, if he Soul Parries, he loses a bunch of guys still. And I don't think he'll have lethal on the swing back, but we'll find out. Let's see, here he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blocks, plus Dispense Justice. We still get in for lethal, and we have 2 guys blocked back to block. So I think that's the best. This way, even if he does Soul Parry, we should not be lethal on the swing back. So currently unblocked are Blight Mamba and Blight Mamba. So we're going to Untamed Might this one for 2. Should be lethal. Then we have Grasp open and a blocker. Oh, he drew a Grasp. Wow. Alright, so this attack didn't work out the best for us, but we're still fine. We still get in for 1 and kill his team. Leaving him with just a Blister Grub. And we're going to go ahead and take out said Blister Grub right now. Or do I even care about Blister Grub? It's got Vigilance, but if I just play Plague Stinger, he's at 7. It's almost lethal. I don't want to die this Blister Grub, but it has 3 attacks plus the damage from it, so I think if I just play Plague Stinger here, it's best for us. And then, yeah. Drew a Gasp, that's pretty sick for him. We're going to take 2. We can also Grasp this guy to not take any damage for a turn, which is pretty important. Another one, wow. Okay, well, that worked out for us. Let's bash him, and then Contagion Engine him to death. Yeah, I suppose we didn't have many cards left in our library, so there weren't a lot of bad things we could draw. Alright, and we got there. Long round, but a profitable round, in which we drew 10 cards in one turn, so that's always good. And we'll be back for round 2.